just had a very quick breakfast. I already had a shower, so I'm all shiny and glowing again. And right now I'm doing my makeup because I have a hair appointment in definitely like less than half an hour. So I have to hurry up because I have to leave in a little bit more than 5 minutes. So otherwise I'm going to be late. And yeah, hi, good morning. Welcome back to my channel. Hi, friends. And I hope you're all doing very well. Today I thought it would be fun to take you guys along with me. I'm going to the IKEA later in the afternoon. And yeah, it's going to be just a very chilled, relaxed day. I also want to mention the books that I've been reading. I'm currently reading Anne of Green Gables. I started this somewhere this week. And I'm really enjoying it so far. It's really cute, it's fun. And I think it's perfect for this time of year. I'm also listening to Eva Under the Sun by Agatha Christie, which I really enjoy. But at the same time, it's also, I think, my least favorite of her works. It's not, I don't know, it's fun to read, but I'm not enjoying it as much as the other ones. And I'm sorry if you hear screaming or something. It's like the school next door, so they're playing outside. But I have to hurry up. I'm going to take you guys along during the day, and I hope you'll have fun. So
a little look of the outfit of today. I'm just wearing some cute jeans and this very cute sweater vest, which I really enjoy. I'm not sure if it's going to be too warm, so I might change during the day. And this is my hair at the moment, a little before look. I'm not going to cut off a lot. I just kind of want to get off the ends and have a little bit more layering in my hair. And excuse the mess behind me, but I don't have time to clean up, so I'm going to do that as soon as I get back. So I just got back from the hairdresser and I really like my haircut. It feels a lot lighter, it feels really nice, and it has a little bit more layering around the face, which I really wanted. So I'm really happy with that. And I also went to a couple of stores while I was there. I tried to buy some new flowers, but unfortunately I didn't buy any because I didn't have the ones I was looking for. And the flowers they had were not really the ones, well, that I wanted, and they were quite expensive, so I didn't buy any. But I also went to the drugstore, and there I picked up a couple of things I needed. I bought a new dry shampoo from the brand Batiste. I've never used this brand, but I see it like a lot around, and I don't know, dry shampoo quite often either is like a miss or a hit, and I don't know, I kind of want to try something out. A new one, because I'm not that happy with the ones I am having at the moment. And I also bought a new e.l.f. mascara. I've never used brand e.l.f., but I've heard a lot of good things, and it's cruelty free, so I kind of want to try it out. And I also decided to treat myself on a new foundation, also from the brand e.l.f., and a new setting powder. I'm not that big of a fan of foundation, but I want to try this one out because it's like a light coverage. So I'm kind of curious to see if this one is a little bit better for my skin. I really hope I picked out the right colors because I'm a little bit suntanned still. So it's probably not the right time to buy new foundation. But yeah, I did. We'll see if the color is a success during the winter. I'm going to make myself a nice cup of coffee, and I really want to make my to-do list for the weekend as well. I always like to write everything down that I kind of want to do or need to be done during the weekend, so I'm going to do that. And I'm also hopefully do some reading, and yeah, I think that's kind of like the plan for the next couple of hours. But when I make a to-do list, I always like to put things on my to-do list that I already did before I made it. Like, for example, I already did a couple of things this morning, and I made a to-do list for my today and the rest of the week, just now. But I already put the stuff that I did this morning on there as well, so it still feels like a productive day, because otherwise I feel I haven't done a lot while I actually did. I don't know, it might be really, really stupid, but I don't know, I kind of like to do those things, so I kind of always put already the stuff down that I already did. So yeah, let me know in the comment section if that's super weird, or if you guys do that as well. So I figured this was also time to talk about our Disney trip announcements. You've probably already seen it in the thumbnail or in the title of this video, but I have a little trip announcement for Disneyland Paris this time. I've been to Walt Disney World, well, we actually came back like a month ago, so my mom laughed out loud after she heard that we actually booked another trip. But yeah, my sister and I did. Last weekend we booked another trip with two friends from my sister as well. So we're going with just four girls, so that's amazing. And we're going in February, 3 days, 2 nights in Sequoia Lodge. It's our second time staying at Sequoia Lodge, and it's probably one of my favorite resorts. It's so pretty, so nice and quiet. So I can't wait to get back there. And yeah, we are going by car. We were considering the train for, I think, like a couple of minutes, but then we are like, no, just take the car. Just for a couple of reasons. We have had pretty bad luck with the train. You can get like the Eurostar in Rotterdam, and then it's like a direct train straight to Disneyland Paris. But we have had some pretty bad luck with it. Like last winter as well, when we went in February, there was like a lot of snow, so the train didn't go, and we ended up actually almost taking a trip for 6 hours before we got there. So it's a lot easier and faster by car. And another reason to go by car as well is we can actually decide when to leave. We don't need to look at the clock or hurry up because you have to catch the train. You can leave whenever you want. So that's definitely a big bonus as well. And we can go by car. It's just a 4.5 hour drive, so that's very easy just to go there. And we leave early in the morning and probably leave late at night to go back home. A whole trip we booked through Disneyland Paris at the website itself, so we have like the park tickets included. We also have early hours, and yeah, I'm super, super excited to go with especially also the friends from my sister, because they love Disney. And so I'm definitely curious to see how that trip is going. Like, for Disney girls walking around, it's probably going to be a lot of fun. I'm also going to vlog the trip. I'm not sure if my sister and her friends are going in to be in their videos, but I'm definitely going to vlog it. And yeah, I just thought it would be fun to already announce it so you guys know where I'm going. You're going at the end of February, and it's the most amazing time to go, to be honest. At least I think so. January, February, it's super cold. You never know what the weather is going to be like. It can be amazing and super nice, but it can also be well, rainy or snowy, and that definitely has sometimes impacts on the attractions or shows. But at the same time, when you're lucky and the weather is nice, it can be very quiet and chill and relaxed to go around that time. So yeah, that's one of the reasons we're going in February. If you have any questions about our trip, just leave them down in the comment section down below. I'm definitely going to do like a video about planning and packing for Disneyland Paris as well, but that's all going to be like later in the year, more towards our trip in February, so probably somewhere in December and January. We're also looking into maybe making a reservation at Captain Jack's. We have never eaten there, and we really want to eat there. We've tried a couple of times. We're always late on making reservations. I'm going to try to make one this weekend. So another really fun thing to look forward to. And now I really have to do some house chores. I'm definitely like postponing it. One of the reasons I kind of wanted to film today, because I don't really want to do everything that I need to be doing. But enough chit chat. I have to vacuum the living room. So the first thing I have to do is clean out all Sissy's toys, because they're leaving around everywhere on the floor. So I have to get them off on the floor, then I can vacuum and make everything nice and neat for the weekend. Thank you. ready for the IKEA trip. My mom is like coming, I think in like a half an hour or something, so I still want to do some editing. I've been listening to Eva Under the Sun while getting ready and doing some house chores. I really enjoy it. No, not really. Like, I do enjoy reading it or listening to it. But I don't know, it's probably one of my least favorite books by Agatha Christie. I know there's always a lot of interrogation going on in those books, but this time I kind of feel it's a little bit more on the heavy side of interrogating. There are a couple of chapters after each other where Poirot was just asking the same questions over and over again. I still enjoy it, don't get me wrong, because I love Agatha Christie and I really enjoy her work, and also really love listening to David Suchet, I think his name is. He plays Poirot in the BBC series. He reads this book and I really enjoy his voice and his narration. But I don't know, it's probably just my least favorite, and also kind of prefer when there are more murders happening, or if there's at least a feeling that they might get another, that someone else might get murdered, and at the moment that feeling isn't really there. So I'm definitely curious to see how everything's going to be wrapped up. I just have like an hour of listening to go, or then I have finished this one. So yeah, I am going to the IKEA with my mom. I'm really excited for it. We're going to have like some dinner and just looking around, and I kind of want to see if I can buy a new couch. Like, you saw like two couches in this video, and one is my sister's and the other one is mine. I've got like the gray smaller one. I've always regretted that size. I want one that's a little bit bigger. So I'm going to see if they have something that I like, and I'm going kind of for the color green. So I'm definitely curious to see if there's something that might catch my eye. Why is she not dressed the same, or has the same makeup on as in the last clip? Well, very simple, it's a different day. I completely forgot to wrap up the vlog yesterday evening. And in all my defense, IKEA trips are just extremely tiring. At least that's how I feel about it. I always get so overwhelmed, and oh, by the way, I'm sorry if you hear some noise. I got the washing machine on, so you might actually hear that. But IKEA trips are so tiring. Like, it's always super overwhelming. I see way too many things I don't need but want to buy. And yeah, we got back not that extremely late, but it was a little bit late. My mom stayed over. We had a nice cup of coffee afterwards, and then she went home. And when she went home, I kind of went straight to bed. I was completely exhausted. So, well, I didn't wrap it up. I didn't film anymore. So that's why I look a little bit different. However, I can actually say a couple of things about some items I showed you at the beginning of this video. For example, I used the dry shampoo yesterday, and as you can see, my hair looks pretty good. It doesn't look that bad. I put it on yesterday before I went to the IKEA, and my hair actually looks still pretty decent. I also put on the e.l.f. mascara, and funny thing, it's brown. Your girl didn't check the color. I didn't even know they had like a brown one. I do know they exist, but somehow I kind of figured that a brown mascara would come in like a brown package. I never thought about checking the color, so I picked up a brown mascara. And to be honest, I kind of like it. I think it's a lot softer. It gives a little bit softer look than the black ones I usually wear. So I'm pretty happy with that. I'll put the links for those products in the description box down below in case you're interested. But anyway, let me show you what I bought at IKEA. To be honest, actually when I'm looking at it now, I kind of want to show you guys what I bought. But it's really nothing interesting. I bought a little lamp that I needed for another lamp that I have. I bought four of these because I've got two lamps that need to be changing, so I've got these. And I also have paper towels for in the kitchen. The design is super adorable. And to be honest, these are come really in handy because they're, you can either get like a bigger piece, like a square one, or you can get like smaller pieces. So it's kind of handy in the kitchen. Another thing I bought is this one. It's a new plate for a bed. I really like the color. I'm not entirely sure yet if I'm going to keep it. I kind of want a green bed sheet, but I don't know. The ones that I wanted were kind of a little bit more too expensive side, a little bit more expensive than I wanted to pay for it. And then I saw this and I figured I could also just buy this and put it on my bed instead of changing the bed sheet or buying new bed sheets. So yeah, I'm going to try this one out. So that's everything I bought at IKEA. Oh no, I also bought like a plant. I'll show you in a clip after this one. And yeah, that's kind of it. Not the most exciting vlog probably, but at least I hope you had fun. I am going to show you some clips after this one of Sissy and me going to my parents. We are going to have a nice quiet afternoon, having dinner. So we're going to spend some time at my parents' house. So I'm going to wrap this vlog up right now and just give you some b-roll at the end. And I hope you stay safe, I hope you're well, and see you guys in the next one, which is going to be a little bit more exciting because I'm going to do a reading vlog for a new book that's coming out next week. And we're also going to decorate the living room in some autumn Halloween theme stuff. So yeah, stay tuned for that and see you guys in the next one. Bye bye!